We are going to discuss about the fishery resources of India, and perhaps all of us, we know that the fishery sector all over the world as well as in India is very important because it provides the employment opportunities, provides day-to-day income generation. It is a very powerful tool for the employment generation and also the resource of cheap and nutritious food, and it is a tool of livelihood for economically backward population. Now, particularly in India, there are 14 million people who are dependent on the fishery sector, particularly the people who are residing in coastal areas as well as the fishermen community of the inland sector. Globally, more than 1 billion people, they are dependent on the fisheries sector. Now, if we look at this particular sector, it is contributing to our national, look at the total contribution to the economic sector, we'll find that contribution of fishery sector to GDP is around 0.83, that means almost 1% to our total GDP. Simultaneously, for the agriculture sector GDP, it is around 4.75, and total export, if we see in the fishery sector, it is around 10.51 million metric tons, which is amounting to around 33.5 crores. And if we look at the financial contribution to the GDP from the fishery sector, around 78 crores of rupees, it is contributing to the national economy. So therefore, the fishery sector is very, very important from the, not only from the food security point of view, but also it is substantially contributing to the national economy. Now, if we look at the major resources of fishery sector, which is contributing to the both marine as well as for the inland fishery sector, we will see from the marine, we will see all over the world, there are different types of fishes. Particularly, the major chunk of marine capture fisheries. If we look at this slide, we will find the Alaska pollock, then the Japanese anchovy, Atlantic herring, skipjack, then there are different species of tunas, and the blue whiting, Japanese Spanish mackerel. Mackerel species are number of mackerel species we come across. Similarly, South American pilchard, Chilean jack mackerel, Japanese flying squid, Atlantic horse mackerel, and chub mackerel. So these are some of the important fishery of the whole world, I mean. And India also, we find there are major resources of fisheries of India. Now, what kind of fish we find in the marine sector as well as in the freshwater sector? Now, there are anchovies, barracudas, Bombay duck, carangids, croakers, clupoids, flatfishes, there are marine shrimps. Then Indian mackerel is a very major important fishery of India. Indian oil sardine is there. Then lizard fishes, mullets, long tail tuna, catfishes, sear fishes, yellow tunas, and shark and rays. These are some of the important marine resources of fish. Now, coming to the most of the world aquaculture has developed in freshwater also. Now, in the freshwater, you will find that in India, if you look at the major fishes, you know, there are number of Indian major carps, then the grass carps, and number of other freshwater fishes. Now, in whole Asia, Asian countries is supposed to be dominated in the freshwater aquaculture, and The enhancement of fish production through aquaculture is observed as an important source of food security all over the world, particularly in the landlocked countries. In India also, because we are having lot of freshwater bodies, that's why the aquaculture sector is growing very fast, and it is one of the sector which is dominating in our country. Particularly if we find the finfishes, there are number of finfishes and silver carps, grass carps and other carps also. Now apart from marine and brackish water resources, we will also find there are resources from the fish resources from the brackish water aquaculture also. Now this brackish water mainly we find in the coastal areas, particularly for example in Pulicate Lake in Odisha, Chilka Lake in Chennai. There are other areas of brackish water areas like in Gulf of Mannar and Arabian coast also we will find number of brackish water bodies. And these brackish water bodies are actually very good resources for the brackish water fishes as well as the prawns. We call them as shrimps. Now the shrimps are very much important because they contribute in our economy, particularly when we talk about seafood export. Now in the seafood export, we find that 65% of the export is carried out by the Empida, and the main component of that seafood export is the shrimp. Now number of fish species that are cultured globally. Now if we look at this, in Africa, North America, South America, Asia, Europe and former USSR. Now the number of species are given around 80, 72, 51. Likewise we find, and in India also, a number of species are cultured in both freshwater as well as in the marine waters. Now if we look at the top 10 culturable items, now all over the world the marine species are cultured, plus the freshwater fishes are also cultured. And if we see globally, what are the top 10 culturable items? Now we find this kelp, Pacific oysters, silver carp, grass carp, common carp, and there are number of unclassified freshwater fishes, but which are very important and commercial fishes. We find algae, and then the other carps. There are number of varieties of carps, and then the scallop, and there are number of molluscan species also. So these are the 10 top species of marine and freshwater which are cultured globally, and they have been classified as a commercial species. Now the fish is very important, and it is a good source of animal protein. And as I have already told you that in the National Food Security Program, this sector plays a very important role, because the requirement of protein which is available to the weaker sections of the society at a very cheaper rate. And that's why the fish is considered as very important animal. Now man has already realized the importance of this particular fish since the long, you know, since the evolution of the human race, because they used to eat fish as their staple food. It has been the sole diet for many inland nations before the evolution of the farming techniques. Now even today the fish supplies around 35 to 60% animal protein. That is very important, because no other food item contains this much amount of protein, and that's why this animal is very good for health, you know. Fish on an average contains about 10 to 22% of protein and 1 to 20% of fat, and 0.5 to 5% of minerals, and carbohydrates are almost very, very meager quantity, and that's why as a food, it is a healthy food. We can consider that this is a very healthy food, particularly for the heart patients as well as for the... Now, number of diseases have been proved that it will be cured by eating fish. Now, fish production has increased from 25 million tons in 1998 to today and around 158 million tons. That is the global figure. I am talking about the globally how much fish has increased from 25 million tons to 158 tons. That means almost around 6 to 7 times enhancement. Average apparent per capita consumption has also increased from 9 kg to 20 kg. That is because the food habits of the people have changed, and that's why you find that the increase in the consumption of the fish also. Now, currently 2/3 of the total food fish supply are obtained from fishing on marine and inland waters, and the remaining 1/3 is derived from the aquaculture. Now, here I would like to mention that aquaculture is progressing very fast, and almost the contribution from the aquaculture, it is going to be almost 50% to the contribution which is made by the capture fisheries. So that's why this aquaculture is growing very fast, and in India is the second country in the world as far as the aquaculture fish production is concerned, and we are sixth in the globally, we are sixth in position as far as the total fish production is concerned. Now, worldwide, around 1 billion people rely on fish. This I have already told you. Our dependence on the fish is usually higher in coastal areas rather than in the inland areas. About 20% of the world population derives at least 20% of its animal protein intake from fish. Now, if we look at the fishery resources, now what are the main resources that if we look at this, now the fishery sector in India is immensely contributing to the countries of economy, providing valuable foreign exchange and employment to millions of people. Around 14 million fishers in the country, they are depending upon the fisheries and aquaculture. This already I have indicated. Now, in global fisheries, India is the sixth largest producer of fish. This I have already indicated, and second in inland fish production. And fish production in the country has been showing an increasing trend, and that has reached today around 9.58 million metric tons. And this is the this particular slide shows the how from 1950 onwards to 2014 and 15, what is the trend, how it has increased the fish production. And today the fish production is around 9.58 million metric tons. In inland sector also, the fishery resources, they comprise of rivers, canals, estuaries, floodplains, wetlands, lagoons, reservoirs, and this sector had enormous production potential to meet the inland fish requirement of the country. So, inland fish production is actually the, there is a lot of potential as far as this sector is concerned. Now, the if we look at the rivers, you know, there are 14 major rivers in our country and 44 medium rivers, and there are innumerable small rivers and desert streams. So, these are the actually resources for the freshwater fishes. So, we call it is genetic resources because a lot of diversity in the fish community we find, and these are the water bodies from where we get the fish. Different riverine systems of the country having combined length of about 29,000 kilometers, which provides the richest fish genetic resources in our country. Now, there are, apart from rivers and small lakes, we find there are a number of reservoirs in our country. For example, small reservoirs, medium reservoirs, large reservoirs, and if you look at the total area of the reservoirs, you will find around 19,370 hectares, you know, million hectares. And likewise, the total area of the reservoirs is around 3.1 million hectares. That is a tremendous scope. And these are the reservoirs where we can develop the freshwater fisheries, freshwater fisheries. Now, if we look at the marine fishery resources, from where the marine fish comes. Now, we are very fortunate enough that our country is a peninsular country, and all along the three sides of the nation we find the water. One side on the east coast, there is the Bay of Bengal, on the other side you find the Arabian Sea, and on the extreme south we find a very big Indian Ocean. Now, if we measure the coastal line, the length of the coastal line is around more than 8,000 kilometers. And we have the exclusive economic zone, we call EEZ. Now, the EEZ is nothing but the 200 nautical miles from the coastal line. And this area is around 2.02 million square kilometers. That is the area, you know. So, this area we are having the right to fish. That means whatever the fish is available in this 200 nautical miles, we have the right on that, and no other country can enter, you know, to venture into this fish resources. We have a very good continental shelf, particularly on the west coast, and this part, this continental shelf is around 5.5 million hectares. Now, apart from that, there are brackish water areas also. We are having around 1.24 million hectares of brackish water areas, and the very less amount of these brackish water areas we have developed for the brackish water fish culture. So, there is a lot of potential for this area also for the development. Marine fish potential, if we look into, now today's potential estimates, that is, these estimates have been estimated by the Ministry of Agriculture, Fishery Department, and it is around 4.5 million tons. That is the estimates, and today we are exploiting around 3.44 million metric tons. That means almost one more million metric ton, there is a possibility for exploitation. Fish production, as far as marine total is concerned, it is 9.58. And then the inland fishery resources, we have already discussed to some extent. Length of the rivers, around 1,91,000. Reservoirs, I have already told you, 3.15 million hectares. Then tanks and ponds, 2.25 million hectares. Then beels, oxbow lakes, derelict water bodies, then there are floodplain, wetlands, estuaries, mangrove swamps, lagoons, inland fish, lagoons, and then the inland fish potential also. Looking at these areas, we estimate under 5 years, we are expecting that our estimation figure is around 10 million metric tons. Today, the inland production is around 6.14 million metric tons. So, under 5 years, we are expecting that this production may go up to 10 million metric tons. Now, harvestable potential of marine fishery resources of EEZ, that already I have mentioned, that is around 4.5 million metric tons. That is the harvestable type, but and there is a lot of scope for demersal fishery. Demersal in the sense, below around 200 meter depth. That is the from the surface water below 200 meter depth, that is called demersal. So that demersal fisheries we may have to exploit using very sophisticated vessels. We don't have the very sophisticated vessel to exploit these fishery resources. So this 1 million metric tons we can exploit using sophisticated vessels. Now similarly in the inland sector also, the resources potential, as I have already told you, around 10 million tons, which takes into account the production from both capture and culture fisheries. Because capture also from reservoirs, from the lakes, we capture the fish. There we cannot culture. Only in the small ponds of 1 to 10 hectares we can culture this fish, and that is what we call aquaculture. And this aquaculture, it is growing very fast, and that has been converted into now aquaculture industry. Now the main thrust of the freshwater aquaculture in the country has been attributed to the fish farmers development agencies. Now there are around 432 fish farmers development agencies, and they give technical support to the fishermen. So they give all kinds of technical support, how to culture the fish and how to bring or how to enhance the fish production in the captive condition. So that is the function of the fish farmers development agencies, and we are having around 432 fish farmers development agencies. Now besides that, in the freshwater also there are cold water fishery resources also, particularly in the North India. There are several mountainous regions, you know, mountainous zones, and from these zones we may have to exploit the cold water fishes, particularly the Indus Valley, and Indus Valley and its tributaries, particularly Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Vyas, Satluj, Bhagirathi and Alaknanda. The total length is around 7000 kilometers, and this is also a very important resource for the fresh water. Now current fishing activities in the hills are very limited, because hills, as you know, getting fish from the hills, particularly because of the extreme climatic conditions, we may have to the habitat of the fish also, it is very limited, and that's why very specific fishes can be only cultured in such climatic conditions. And that's why now there are government institutions who are trying to develop the technology, you know, for doing the aquaculture of cold water fishes. Now this particular chart shows about FFD, that is fish farmer development agencies, and total area covered by them, and fish farmers trained, how many, because their function is also to train the fish farmers. They give training in all aspects of how to culture the fish. There are number of total beneficiaries, and the average productivity is around today the national productivity, that is 2800 kg per hectare, that is the national productivity. Now highest production, it has been recorded in Punjab, and that is around 4.7 thousand tons per kg per hectare. And lowest production in Gujarat, it is around 1200. So this can be enhanced by adopting the scientific methods, modern techniques, and that's why almost all institutions functioning under state as well as under the central government, which are related to fisheries development, they are doing all kinds of work, innovations in the technology, particularly to enhance the aquaculture production. Besides that, we find the coastal aquaculture also, and this coastal aquaculture, as I told you, there is a lot of possibility of enhancing the coastal aquaculture. So Besides that, you will find also the shrimp production. Now, shrimp, as I told you, it is a seafood export. Around 65% of the seafood export we do with the shrimp. And shrimp is also one of the important resources of marine resource. Now, future projections, I already indicated by 2020, around 12 million metric tons, that is what we are estimating the production. And to support all these things, we are having the different facilities like fishing harbors. And in fishing harbors also, there are minor fish harbors, major fish harbors, and fish landing centers also. So these are all infrastructure that supports the marine fisheries. And in the conclusion, we can say that considering the growing demand of animal protein, substitution of fish as a cheap source of quality protein is the best proposition. So fish is good for good source for nutritious food and ensures security from starvation and malnutrition. Now, fish also generates employment opportunities. And as I told you, it also contributes to national and economic gains. And fish for food, fish for health, and fish for income ensures overall security. Now, some of the important resources of fish I would like to show here. This is the Labrio rohita, that is we commonly called rohu, which is a very important source of fresh water. This is the grass carp. This is Katla Katla, another very important Indian major carp. This is a common carp, which again comes under Indian major carps. This is Mrigal fish, Katla, Rohu and Mrigal. These are the three important fishes of Indian major carps, and we culture them heavily. These are the Magur fishes. We also call them as catfishes. They are all freshwater. And as far as marine is concerned, tuna is very important fish. Then there are anchovies, Bombay duck, there are Indian oil sardines, Indian mackerel, and last one, the shrimp. Now there are 60 species of shrimp, and out of which the tiger shrimp is one of the most costliest fish. Around 1 kg of fish, it may fetch 1 lakh rupees. And that is how it is a very good resource of our Indian coastal areas. So with this, I thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to tell something about fishery resources of India. Thank you very much.